Our first guest is a major motion picture star and also television star. Well, a former television star and now a major motion picture star. His latest film is called Folks, soon to be released or released now, Bob? Soon to be released. Three for three. Ladies and gentlemen, here he is, our good friend Tom Selleck. Tom? Tom, good to see you.
Good to see you.
How have you been?
I've been good. I've been taking a little time off because I worked for about 8 months in a row, staying home more.
Yeah. Now, work 8 months in a row, is that one movie or two movies or one movie and a lot of other things?
I did three movies in like 8 months.
Wow.
Yeah.
Which three? Are they all waiting to be released?
They're all waiting. Yeah, I'm going to be talking a lot.
Okay, what's the first one? Folks is coming out.
Right,
and then the other two are?
This summer's a movie called Mr. Baseball about an American player who goes to Japan at the end of his career.
And that's a great idea for a movie.
I think so.
Yeah, I do too.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, because...
Well, it is.
No, you should mention that.
Yeah. And then the other one is...
Is Christopher Columbus, The Discovery. There's two movies. There's two Columbus movies. And they shot at the same time, so they get a little sensitive. Christopher Columbus, The Discovery, and I play Ferdinand, King of all of Spain.
Uh-huh. And now, is this a historically accurate film? Is it a comedy? Is it a...
No, it's not a comedy. I get to work with Marlon Brando in it.
So this is like a big, really serious recreation of the...
It's huge. Yeah. I mean, I only work 7 days, but it's a big picture.
Out of that, what do you want to talk about? Let's talk a little bit about the baseball. You want to?
Yeah.
When you were an undergrad at USC, is that where you went to school?
Yeah.
University of Southern California.
Yeah.
You played basketball?
Basketball and volleyball. I played baseball through junior college. Mm-hmm. And
where'd you go to junior college?
Valley.
The Valley College in Los Angeles?
Yeah, San Fernando Valley.
And you played ball there?
Played baseball there, and every day of my life before that.
Uh-huh.
So
this for you was like a kid playing baseball. That was the way it was supposed to be.
Well, if I had two fantasies as an actor, one would be to do a Western, which I just got to do a big Western, and one would be to do baseball movies.
Yeah.
So it's been great.
And what position did you play?
First base, the only position I never played during an illustrious career.
Was?
First base.
Oh, it was first base.
It's a trick question.
No, I'm sorry. You said the only position you never played?
I never played, yeah. Yeah.
Oh, I see. You're having a little fun at your own expense.
No, I'm not. No, I didn't. I never played first base, and I had no idea. You know, that was always where you stuck the big guy.
Yeah.
You know, who couldn't do anything in Little League and all. So I had no idea how complex it was and how hard it was, but... I had a lot of fun learning. I went to spring training with the Tigers.
I'm still confused. You played first base or you didn't play first base?
In the movie, I played a first baseman.
Right, but as a kid, and playing in the Valley...
Never. I was a shortstop.
Oh, thank God. You see, when there is that level of confusion, I worry that I've had one of those spells. You see? And I get panicky that I've missed something very important. Yeah. I'm sorry.
No, I never, ever, played first base
except
until this movie.
In the movie. Okay, yeah. Okay. But you spent a lot of time in spring training this year playing with your team, the Detroit Tigers, right?
Yeah, last year. I went for 2 weeks, the beginning of spring training the first week and the end of spring training. And it was real interesting going back because... there were a lot of empty lockers, you know, because guys had been cutting all
moved
that.
On, sure.
Moved down to AAA or whatever. And then the last week I was there, the last five or six guys had to go. So when a guy gets called in the manager's office, everybody knows.
Yeah. Yeah. Now, how did they treat you? Because I'm thinking that I would, if it were me, I'd be worried that these ball players, some of them hanging on for their lives, some of them hanging on for their careers, and all of a sudden, Mr. Hollywood comes in to knock fungos to the kids.
I know. I was kind of worried about that, and I tried as hard as I could not to get in the way, but they let me do everything, I wasn't sure I really belonged until about my second week there, my first day back. I got Kramer's atomic bomb in my jockstrap.
This is that kind of...
This is that ritual of acceptance from the ball player.
Yeah, but the Kramer, it's like an analgesic, you rub
it's
on...
It's a heat
and
rub. It's a heat rub.
Very, very
yeah.
hot.
It's, and it struck me in the shower that they like me. I was trying to get it off. So every day after that, I'd have to smell and taste and study all items of clothing before I put them on. They put skin lube in my shoes.
Yeah.
I was sitting talking to Al Kaline for about a half hour. My toes felt real squishy, and they'd put this anti-blister lubricant solidly in the inside of my baseball shoes. It was fun. Yeah.
But for you, that meant you were...
That was everything, right. Because they don't like you if they won't kid you.
I have another question for our producer, Robert Bob Morty Morton. Do we have videotape of Mr. Selleck at spring training? Excellent. Yeah, this is very impressive. You get to see Tom here in an actual spring training game with the Cincinnati Reds. You're playing for the Tigers, right?
You got it at bat.
Very exciting, and we'll look at that when we come back here, folks, with Tom Selleck. Where were we here? You want to
baseball.
Tell folks, baseball, you're in spring training. This is a year ago?
Yeah, I'm in spring training the last week, and Sparky said to me, he says, you're not going to really know what this is like unless you get an at-bat. So they may reprimand me, but I'm gonna stick you in a game.
They knew you were down there getting ready for this film, right?
Yeah, and the Reds were world champs at the time, and we were playing the Reds, and he said, I'm going to pinch hit you for Rob Deere in the seventh inning, and guess who came in to pitch? Rob Dibble.
Oh, my.
Yeah. So they didn't pinch hit me in the seventh inning.
Yeah.
They pinch hit me in the eighth inning with a guy came in to pitch named Tim Liana with the best knuckle curve ball, obviously, in the major leagues when you see
what exactly is the knuckle curve?
I don't know, but it drops about a foot. I don't know how you throw it, mm-hmm. but it's not a knuckle ball, but it just, the bottom drops right out of it. Well, mm-hmm.
It's
You'll
an off-speed
it
pitch, yeah. breaking ball, odd kind of thing.
Yeah, and, you know, they're not very fair in the major leagues because they don't throw all the pitches at the same speed. It really bothered me. It's not like batting practice, which I was getting pretty confident
You know, I think
about.
In some countries that knuckle curve is illegal, Tom. So don't be too hard on yourself. All right, so let's roll this videotape here and then see what he's talking about. When I saw this, I found this whole thing very, very impressive, and it must have been terribly exciting for you. Here he is standing in. Whoa! You get a pretty good piece there.
It's Chris Sabo.
Yeah. So what were you thinking there? Your heart must have been just pounding. Oh,
that's the knuckle
curve.
That
was the knuckle curve. Yeah, that one is off speed and the bottom just dropped out.
Yeah. But it was... you know how you dig in, kind of... In the batter's box, I kept digging in. I could not feel the ground. I hung in there for about seven pitches. I fouled about three off, but it was the time of my life.
Were you thinking to yourself, I mean, it would have been wonderful if you could have connected and actually gotten a base hit.
But Tim Liana wants to be in the major leagues. He doesn't want some goofy actor.
Yeah.
You know? I mean, they were really serious. Yeah, there it is again.
Yeah, they don't want Magnum taking him deep.
No. Because on a rare occasion, I might have got lucky. And I went back to the dugout, and the Tigers thought it was... They said, that sure is cold. He threw you a knuckle curve. I mean...
Yeah.
So I felt like, number one, the guys liked me because of the atomic bomb, and they didn't want the guy to throw me a knuckle curve.
But, you know, when you look at... When you look at the entire at-bat, it's not just you striking out. I mean, you work the pitcher in a manner.
It was forever.
Yeah.
I mean, it was like seven pitches. Yeah. That's
very
I did okay.
Now, we have another bit of videotape, and I'm not exactly clear what this is. You brought this for us.
I did. It's like a home movie. You changed my life, Dave.
Thank you.
No, you did. You did. I moved into a ranch about, like, 3 years ago outside L.A., and when I first walked the ranch... I realized that we did not have an unlimited supply of gas. I saw this little propane tank, and something just clicked in my head, and I remembered a show you did. And ever since then, I've been trying to find this woman who cooks from alternative energy sources.
Right.
In this case, she cooks with a dishwasher, and so we made this tape.
This woman was a guest on our show years and years ago. And she prepares entire meals using the gas-powered dishwasher.
No, the electric-powered dishwasher.
Electric-powered dishwasher.
I have to save propane.
Oh, I see. Yeah. There. That's what started the wheel spinning for you.
Yeah. Yeah. It okay. really kind of just clicked in my head, and she's our cook now.
She is your cook?
Yeah, honestly.
All right, we have videotape. All right. Yeah. Let's take a look at this. What's her name?
Lynn Dakin.
Lynn Dakin. This is the... There she is. What is that?
Yeah, a big roast turkey.
Roast
Ooh.
Turkey.
Oh, say hi to Dave.
Hi, Dave.
You changed our lives, Dave.
Yes.
Here comes.
And a surprise.
Wow, that looks delicious. Don't you think? Are you so fancy?
You're welcome.
Okay. Thanks, Lynn. I'll eat in a little while.
Well. I couldn't be happier.
You remember her?
I do. It's about 5 years ago.
Yeah, well, turkey's kind of really going for it. Turkey's a little tough. And
turkey
there's a few
and
bugs.
Suds.
Yeah.
Paul and I were going to invest in a chain of restaurants by that name a few years ago.
Turkey and Suds, yeah.
Turkey, you need about 20 cycles on the dishwasher to cook right.
Well, I'm happy I could help.
Thanks.
Good to see you. The movie Folks, we didn't even... do we want to see part of that movie, Bob? No, Bob says no.
Bob says no.
How long is that clip? Just show a little of the clip. Here it is. This is Folks. Just a little of the clip. This is Tom Selleck, because he's been so nice. And
I am not going to go away, Arlene. I am your brother. And they're your parents. And you're going to take care of them for a while when Mom gets out of the hospital.
Oh, that's just what I need. Great husband bait. Two kids and a pair of invalids. They'll be knocking on my
door. You get the idea, though. You get the idea. Good to see you. Good luck with everything. Tom Selleck. We'll be right back.